suspended. One thing I'm gonna ask you to do is when you start talking, that you have to speak up, okay, kind of like I am. Otherwise, the thing won't pick up real well. But before we ask any questions, Brendan, I have to read your rights. It's just what we have to do. One of those things, okay? Before we ask any questions, you must understand your rights. You have the right to, you have the right to talk to a lawyer for advice before we ask you any questions and have him with you during questioning. You have this right to the advice and presence of a lawyer, even though you cannot afford to hire one. We have no way of giving you a lawyer, but one will be appointed for you if you wish, and if and when you go to court. If you wish to answer questions now without a lawyer present, you have questions at any time until you talk to a lawyer. I have read the above statement of my rights. I understand what my rights are. I am willing to answer questions and to make statements. I do not want a lawyer. I understand and know what I am doing. No promises or threats have been made to me, and no pressure of any kind has been used against me. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
You have to speak up a little bit.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. And if you agree with making a statement, why don't you put your initials here and put your initials here? These are the two things I read to you. Okay. And I'm just going to put the place up here, Two Rivers Police Department. And the time is approximately 3:21 p.m. There for now. Brandon, just a few things. Okay, we're going to talk about what she had initially told us earlier. Okay. How old are you?
16.
Okay. What's your address, Brandon?
12938 Road.
What city?
Wisconsin.
Okay.
The truth is something that is like something that's true, like something that really happened.
And you have to speak up again, okay? And what's a lie?
It's something that's false.
Okay, so if I said that I was wearing a red shirt, would that be a truth or a lie?
A lie. Truth.
Okay. Do you agree to tell us the truth today?
Yeah.
And if we ask you something you don't know the answer to, just tell us you don't know?
Yeah.
Okay. Who do you all live with, Brent?
My mom and my three brothers.
Your mom and your three brothers? What are your three brothers' names?
Wayne, Bobby, and Brian.
Okay.
Avery.
Okay, and how is he related to you?
My sister's brother.
So that makes him what to you?
My uncle.
Okay. Well, what we want to talk to you about, Brendan, like we had talked about before, is October 31st of 2005. Okay. Do you remember that day?
Yeah.
Okay. Tell us about that day when you came.
I got off the bus at 3:45 and I seen a Jeep down by our house, and I went into my house and I played PlayStation 2 for 3 hours. I ate at 8 o'clock, and I got a phone call from Steven. And I said, yeah, and then he told me to bring the golf cart over. So I did, and then he drove me around seat and some wood. And the seat off. And later on, I seen her forehead and her belly.
Okay, I'm just going to stop you there. You said when you got home, you saw her Jeep. Whose Jeep was that, do you think?
Hers.
Who's her?
Teresa Hallbach.
Okay. Do you remember what it looked like?
Green. And
that night after you got a call from Steven, you said?
Yeah.
What time was that?
At 9:30.
9:30 at night?
Yeah.
And what date was that on?
October 31st.
And was there a fire going already at that time?
Yeah.
And who was at the fire at that time?
Steven.
Anybody else?
No.
Okay.
Like some wood and some like a broken cabinet.
And how did you pick those up?
We picked them up with our hands and put them in the go-kart.
Okay, and then where did you take them?
Over by the fire, and we set it on the ground.
Okay, you said before you saw something in the fire. What did you see?
Your foot, your toes.
Describe where you saw them.
Like on the side of the fire.
And where was it, under something?
Under some tires and some branches.
Okay. Had Steven brought something out to tend the fire with at all?
Some gas.
Did he use gas to make it
like a shovel and a rake?
Okay.
Did you see anything else in the fire besides toes?
A hand and forehead and your belly.
Did it look like she was in one piece, or did it look like she was chopped up, or what did it look like?
In one piece.
When you said
it looked like some fat or something.
How did you know it was a forehead?
There's like some ziggly lines on it.
Would have been in the, if I had you draw a picture, could you draw like that pit area and kind of draw in what you saw and where you saw it? Okay. How about if I do that now? I'll give you a pen.
In the back of his garage, or behind the garage.
Behind Steven's garage?
Yeah.
Put an H where his house would be and a G where his garage would be. So what you drew here, can you just explain what you drew here? Where were you standing when you saw her? Put an X there.
Okay.
Could you put your initials so I know that's you? And maybe another X where he was standing?
Right there.
Okay.
And then you guys put more stuff on the fire?
Yeah, when it went down.
And what did you... Okay, and how was it that you were able to see her? Were things moved around, or was it just because the fire went down?
Well, he moved it around so I could see it.
How did he move it around?
With a shovel.
So explain to me what you mean, he moved it around. Tell me what you mean.
He like shifted it around, like kind of smoothed it over.
did that, what did you see?
Her fingers and her head, her forehead.
Okay. What happened next?
We went over. He went into the garage, I went to his house and got the garbage bags. Before that, we started.
Did you guys talk about what you saw in there?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me about that.
I see it, he said, he seen me see it, so he told me not to say something, or else he'll, he threatened me a little bit.
How did he threaten you? What did he say?
That he would.
What else did he tell you about what you saw?
That.
Did he tell you what it was?
That it was her body.
Did he tell you whose body?
Teresa Hallbach's.
What did he tell you? How did it get there?
That he put it there with like a, he drove it there.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Could you say that?
What?
With his sled?
His mobile sled.
Is that what he told you?
Yeah.
Did he tell you anything about what happened to her prior to that?
They tied her up in her Jeep and stabbed her in the stomach.
And then what did he do?
Then he put the knife under the seat and tried to hide the Jeep.
And did he tell you where?
Behind, in the woods area.
In the woods area where?
Down in the pit by the lake or the pond. Branches over in a car hood.
You mentioned a sled. Is that a sled that you pulled behind something?
Yeah.
Do you know what he pulled the sled with when he took it over there, or did he just pull it itself?
I think he pulled it by itself.
Did you ever see that sled?
Mm-hmm.
Does he have a sled?
Yeah.
Where is that sled?
Oh, in the garage.
What's it look like?
Black.
What's it, I'm sorry, what's it made out of?
Plastic or rubber or like a fishing thing.
Did he tell you why he did this to Teresa?
Because he was.
Did he tell you why he was angry?
No.
Did he throw anything else on the fire?
Some garbage.
Yeah, anything else?
Some clothes that had blood stain cut in it.
Describe the clothes for us.
The shirt was blue and the pants were.
They look like what gender clothing would they have been?
Girl clothes.
Did he say whose clothes they were?
Yeah.
And whose were they?
Teresa Hallbach.
And you said something about blood on them. On what article of clothing was the blood on?
The shirt.
And you said there was a hole in the shirt. About where was that?
In the stomach.
Could you just point?
Did he say anything about that hole?
No.
Okay.
Did he tell you when he did this?
No.
How has this affected you?
Yeah, I've been sad for the last 3-4 months.
What have you been sad about?
I thought that he didn't do it and felt sorry for Teresa's family.
Did you have anything to do with stab her?
No.
Did you help put the body in the fire?
No.
Did anybody else?
Not that I know of.
Have you told anyone else about this?
No.
Have you told your mother?
No.
Is your mother here today?
Yeah.
Anything else about Teresa?
Yeah, that she was pretty.
What else did he say about her, if anything?
No.
Do you know what sexual assault means? Did he say anything about wanting to?
No.
So just so I'm clear on this, where did he say that he stabbed her?
In the stomach.
And that occurred where? Outside, inside, in the truck, where?
In the Jeep.
The Jeep. What color the pants were? Do you remember what color the shirt was?
Blue.
What, was it a t-shirt or a button-up shirt or what type of shirt?
Like a button-up shirt.
What about shoes? Did you see any shoes at all?
No.
Did you see any camera or cell phone anywhere?
No.
When you saw her in the fire, she have shoes on?
No.
So you saw what?
Her toes and her feet.
Was there still skin on her toes and feet?
Yeah.
Was it? What color was it?
A peach or and a little bit of white.
So just so I'm clear on this, he told you who it was?
Yeah.
And he told you it was who?
Teresa Alba.
How long were you by the fire?
Oh, 2 hours.
Were you scared when you saw what you saw?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell anybody?
I was scared to.
What were you scared about?
Because they would think that I helped them.
Is there anything else that you can think of?
Did he tell you how he got the truck back into the pit?
He drove it.
Which way did he drive it?
Past Chucky's house.
Did he say when he did that?
Like the day on October 31st.
You told me before that he told you that he stabbed her in the stomach?
Yeah.
Where did he do that? In the house, in the garage?
In the Jeep.
In the Jeep. And where was the Jeep? Do you know how he got her from the pit up to the fire pit?
By a slide.
say which way he brought her up?
No.
And you told me before that he tie her up.
Rope.
Anything else?
No.
Do you have any questions?
No.
Is there anything we forgot to ask?
Was this hard for you to do?
Yeah.
I can imagine. And there's no doubt in your mind what you saw in that fire. Pardon?
Yeah.
You know what that was. When Stephen was up north with you that week, or at the end of that week, that next week, and the police came up there, what did he say?
He said, drive as hard as he can to get away.
To get away from?
The cops.
Okay. Has he said anything else to you since that night? When we wanted to talk to you and stuff, did he say anything to you about what you should say? Has he threatened you since that night, or told you don't say anything or anything like that since that night?
No.
Do you know whose knife it was?
No.
Do you know where the knife is now?
No.
Give your other notes.
Would you okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think we're going to do that, okay?
Thank you, Brendan.
Just hang in there, right? How you doing? Hanging in there? All right. I've got a few more questions for you, okay? Did you help him put
Crave Jeep and put it in the garage.
It's a Jeep or?
It's a Suzuki.
And where was that located before you put it in the garage?
On the side of the garage.
Do you know his girlfriend, his fiance, Stevens? You saw Jody.
Before she went to jail.
Do you remember about what month that was?
No.
No. And when's the last time you talked to Jody?
Like 2 or 3 days before she went in.
Okay. Has Steven said anything to you about her? In any relation to what he did? That he did this?
No.
Has he blamed her in any way?
No.
I'm trying to understand what he might have been mad about. Do you have any idea what he was angry about that day?
No.
Did you ask him?
No. Yeah.
To haul some items around. Whose golf cart were you using?
My mom's.
And what's your mom's first name?
Barb.
Barb.
So, to understand this, according to Stephen, and what you just said that Stephen said, he had her down in the pit and then brought her up from the pit and put her in the fire.
Do you know where he got the rope from to tie her up?
No.
Could you see that? Could you see that she was tied up or not in the fire?
No.
Did he have her wrapped up in anything at any time?
No.
Anything that we're forgetting to ask, Brendan?
No.
Because now is the time. You have to tell us if there is. Think real hard. You said you threw some white bags in the fire. What was in those bags?
Garbage. Garbage.
You said he called you and asked you to come out in the fire. Did he call you on the phone or yell in the door? Or what?
And you stayed at the fire until what time?
10:30.
10:30. Do you know how long he stayed out there?
Probably 11:30.
How do you know that?
Because my brother came home and he was still out there.
Your brother? Which brother came home?
Blaine.
Blaine. And what did
that was at what time?
At 11:30.
Do you know what he was going to do with the fire pit?
He was going to build up it and then cover it up and start a new one.
How was he going to do that? Just explain to me what you mean by build up it and try to make a new one. Was he going to fill it with dirt or keep burning stuff? Or exactly what was he going to do, do you think? Or what did he tell you?
He was going to keep on burning stuff. And yeah, so his yard would be all flat instead of all bumpy.
And then he was going to do what, did you say, after that?
He was going to...
to put a new fire pit back there?
Yeah. Not that old.
Do you think Chucky may have saw something?
Probably.
Why do you think that? Were you there?
No. I seen Chucky come down with his truck.
Do you know what they talked about?
No.
Did you ever ask Chucky?
No.
Did Chucky ever tell you anything about this?
No.
Did you ever tell Chucky anything about this?
No.
November. What time did you see Chucky come down by, Steve?
5:30.
5:30 at night?
Yeah.
And where did Chucky go when he came down by, Steve?
By the garage. She was working on his Monte.
Who was working on his Monte?
Yeah, Steve. Garage.
How'd the Monte get in the garage? I thought you told us before that the Suzuki was in the garage, you helped him push it in there.
He had to fix something on it.
So where was the Suzuki when he was working on the Monte?
Probably outside.
Garage?
Talking to Steve.
Are you sure that was the next day? Did you notice any marks on Steven at all?
On his arm.
Where on his arm?
Like the here.
Do you remember which arm?
His left.
His left arm? How did he get that mark?
Well, he said that he got it from working up by the yard, that he cut himself with glass.
Okay. Did he tell you anything else about that mark?
No.
Did he tell you that at any time that he had been injured when he had killed Teresa? Where was that scratch?
Right on his finger.
Okay.
How do you say he got that scratch?
Yeah.
Did he tell you that?
Yeah.
So tell me again exactly what he told you.
That he got it from someone scratching him.
Did he tell you who? Was there a struggle or something, or what did he say?
Yeah, there was a struggle.
Tell me about that. What did he tell you?
When he was trying to tie her up, she tried to get over and scratch him. Trying to get away from him. And she couldn't, so he tied her up and stabbed her.
Leaving or anything? Did he say anything about that?
No.
So he actually showed you the finger?
Yeah.
And which finger was it? See anything on that finger?
Yeah, a scratch.
When he's telling you about this stuff, did he at any time apologize for doing this to her?
No.
What did you say to him about this? told you what he did?
I felt sad.
Sad because what?
That he did it, and felt sorry for Teresa's family.
Did you ever meet Teresa before that?
No.
Did Steve ever meet her before that?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Because we had a link in for her sale, and we wanted to put it in the book, so she came again.
Did you ever see her truck before that day?
No.
Her truck after he told you where it was?
Brendan, you may have answered this, at least indirectly. After you saw what you saw and Stephen told you what he told you, why didn't you go to the police?
Because I was scared too. That I would get in trouble too.
Any other reasons?
If Steven were to get out on bond tomorrow, would you be scared?
Yeah. Because he would probably try to kill me or something.
Why do you think that?
You're telling me.
Why do you think he'd try to kill you though? I mean, what would make you think he would do that?
He told me not to say nothing, so, and I did, so he would.
Did he say anything else when he was trying to tie her up? You told me before that she was trying to struggle and get away, and that's when he got scratched by her, right?
Yeah.
Did he say if he got kicked by her or anything like that?
No.
Did he say if he took any of her valuables, any money, anything like that?
No.
Did you ask him about it?
No.
Did you have trouble sleeping that night?
Sort of.
Why?
Trying to figure out why he did it.
Did you ever ask him after that night? Why he did it?
No.
I have nothing further.
Is there anything else you want to say, Brandon, to the, you know, this is being recorded, to the recording or anything?
Is everything you told Agent Fassbender and myself the truth?
Yeah.
Did you lie at all during this conversation?
No.
Have you lied to us at all about anything you told us?
No.
I appreciate you. I'm going to sign this in front of you as a witness, though, okay? Now the day in there. And time.